Hi friends, today I have something to share with you that is about DKA, diabetic ketoacidosis. Diabetes, something related to sugar. Oh, so sweet. It is very nice to hear, but it is not really to experience. It is the seventh leading cause of death as per WHO, and every day the prevalence of diabetes is rising. DKA is one of the serious complications in diabetes, and it will cause death if not properly managed. As a healthcare worker, we have a major role in diagnosing and managing of DKA. Let's review about DKA. You know where the ketones are coming from? Let me explain for you. Sugar is the major source of energy for muscles and other body tissues. Insulin is allowing the sugar to enter in the cells where it can be turned to energy. Without enough insulin, the body cannot utilize the sugar. So it will start to break down the fat as a fuel. As a byproduct of this process, an acid will form, called ketones. If there is more acid, it will turn to acidosis and eventually leading to diabetic ketoacidosis if untreated. Let's see more about pathophysiology. Okay, pathophysiology. Secondary to insulin deficiency and the action of counter-regulatory hormones, blood glucose increases, leading to hyperglycemia and glucosuria. Glucosuria causes an osmotic diuresis, leading to sodium and water loss. In the absence of insulin activity, the body fails to utilize glucose as fuel and uses fat instead. This leads to ketosis. The excess of ketone bodies will cause metabolic acidosis, later also aggravated by lactic acidosis caused by the dehydration and poor tissue perfusion. Vomiting due to an ileus plus increased insensible loss due to tachypnea will worsen the state of dehydration. Electrolyte abnormalities are secondary to their loss in urine and transmembrane alterations, following acidosis and osmotic diuresis. Because of acidosis, potassium ions enter the circulation, leading to hyperkalemia. This is aggravated by dehydration and renal failure. So depending on the duration of DKA, serum potassium at diagnosis may be high, normal or low. But intracellular potassium levels are always depleted. Phosphate depletion will also take place due to metabolic acidosis. No loss occurs secondary to the hyperosmotic state, the osmotic diuresis. The dehydration can lead to decreased kidney perfusion and acute renal failure. Accumulation of ketones bodies contributes to abnormal pain and vomiting. The increasing acidosis leads to acidotic breathing and acetone smell in the breath and eventually cause coma. Next, we will see the precipitating factors. Here, new onset of type 1 DM, infections, drugs like steroids, thiazides and terbutaline, and omission of insulin. This may be because of unavailability of insulin or maybe not proper education about the insulin. And next we will see diagnosis. You should suspect DKA if a diabetic patient presents with dehydration, acidotic breathing with the fruity smell, abdominal pain or distension, vomiting and altered mental status or coma. To diagnose DKA, the following criteria must be fulfilled. What are they? Hyperglycemia of more than 300 mg per deciliter and glucosuria, and ketonemia and ketonuria. Metabolic acidosis, pH is less than 7.25, bicarb less than 15, and anion gap is more than 10. Anion gap means sodium plus potassium minus chloride plus bicarb. This is usually accompanied with severe dehydration and electrolyte imbalance. Here we will see the line of management. The management step includes assessment of causes and sequelae of DKA by taking a short history. In history, just look for symptoms of hyperglycemia, precipitating factors as we discussed before, diet and insulin dose. Then look for dehydration, electrolyte imbalance, acidotic breathing or any sign of infection, etc. Quick diagnosis of DKA in ER. Like non-diabetic children, look for ketonuria and acidosis. For newly diagnosed children, be careful not to miss. It may mimic like other serious infections, and use glucometer and ketone strip to save the time. And baseline investigations.
we need to check for blood sugar and ketones, ABG, electrolytes, CBC, and chest X-ray as well. And treatment, monitoring, and avoid complications. This we will see in the next slides. Transition to OPD management. Here we will see the treatment of DKA. Principles of treatments include careful replacement of fluid deficit. In that, check for hypovolemic shock. Consider if it is in shock, consider plasma expanders as a bolus 20 to 30 ml per kg. If not in shock, we can give normoseline 10 ml per kg per hour to restore the renal perfusion and blood volume. The second one is correction of acidosis and hyperglycemia via insulin infusion. Make sure optimally serum glucose should decrease in the rate of no faster than 100 mg per dl per hour. Better to avoid rapid decline in the blood sugar during insulin therapy. It may cause another complications. Then correction of acidosis. Usually insulin therapy stops lipolysis and promotes the metabolism of ketone bodies. This together with the correction of dehydration normalizes the blood pH. Bicarbonate therapy should be avoided unless acidosis pH less than 7 and results in hemodynamic instability. The third one is correction of electrolyte imbalance. As soon as the urine output is restored, potassium supplement must be added to the IV and correction of other electrolytes accordingly. Treatment of underlying cause. If it is coming with infection, you should be adding antibiotic for in the line of treatment. And monitoring of complications. Monitoring includes check the blood sugar must be hourly, electrolyte 2 to 3 hourly, neurologic and mental state check frequently, and vital signs continuously. Manage DKA in ICU setup to get intensive attention to the patient. These are the serious complications of DKA: cerebral edema, intracranial thrombosis or infection, acute tubular necrosis, and peripheral edema.
Prevention is better than cure. All the diabetic patients are at risk for DKA and other complications if not well maintained their blood sugar and lifestyle. For that, all what we have to do is proper health education. Educate your patient how they can maintain their blood sugar, lifestyle, and habits. And give them awareness about the consequences of diabetes. I hope you enjoy my class, and thank you for your time. Bye bye.